What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo from the BTNHD, and today is all about Snipe-IT open source asset management installations, and it's a long one, so bear with me, and let's get right into it. All right, so before we even start of how I got this guy installed within a Windows environment, I will provide all the links that we go over during the video at the bottom at the comment section, okay? All right, so on the desktop, I am going to right-click on my start menu, go to run, type in WinVer, hit OK, and I'm running everything within a Windows Server 2019, okay? Now, on the desktop, I am going to click on Start, open up Server Manager, and on the upper right side, I'm going to click on Manage, Add Roles and Features, and then from here, click on Next, 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 we need to locate the web server IIS and give it a check mark, and then just make sure you add all the features and then click next there. We are going to check off .NET framework and then click on next, next again. I left everything as the default, click next. From here, just check off restart the destination server automatically if required. Click yes here, click install. It's going to start installing and you're done. Click on your start menu, open up Windows Administrative Tools, and then open up your IIS Manager. And then there you go, good to go. Now we need to install the URL rewrite. Click on install this extension. Once it's finished downloading, you're going to click on it. It's going to start loading up. It's going to launch up the web platform installer. Click install here. You're going to accept the license and term. It's going to start installing. And you're done. Awesome. Now we need to download MariaDB. I am going to download MariaDB 10.4. So click on the button that says download 10.4.12. It's going to take you here, and we are going to download the Windows x64 MSI file. And once it's completed, click on it. It's going to prepare to install. You get the nice little wizard. I'm going to leave everything as the default. So just click next here. Accept the license and terms. Click next. Next, provide a root password and confirm it, and then click on next, 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 install, and you're done, and then click finish. On the desktop, we are going to click on start and locate Microsoft Web Platform Installer. Once it launches up, we are going to head to products, and we need to locate the PHP 7.4.1. We are going to click on add, install, click on I accept. It's going to start installing. Everything works well, except that we need to manually install the PHP Manager for IIS as well as the Windows Cache extension. All right, so click finish there and head over to this website and click on download this extension. Click OK here. Once it's done, click on the MSI file. It's going to launch up the wizard. Click next. Accept the license and terms. Click next. It's going to start installing the PHP Manager for the IIS. And once it's done, click on close. Open up your IIS manager and you're going to see that it was installed. Your PHP manager. Awesome. Right there. Now we need to download the Windows cache and click on the button that says download. Once it's downloaded, click on the exe file to launch it up. Click yes here. And we need to provide a path to drop the files into. I'm going to click on browse. Going to drop everything inside the desktop. Click OK. And we're done. Within the information dialog box, you need to read this particular file. So we are going to click OK. And we're going to launch the WinCache underscore readme file. The reason that we're launching this is because we need to do a couple of things to get this up and running. So look at the installation part and just follow it. We need to open up the ext folder. And we need to drop that DLL file, which is the PHP underscore WinCache. Right, drop it in there. We also need to locate the php.ini file. So we are going to right click on it. We're going to edit, and it's going to launch up. We're going to go all the way to the bottom, and we need to add the following extension. Now, we're going to open up our favorite browser. We're going to type in the following address, hit enter. It's going to download the composer for us, and once it's completed, click on the exe file to launch it up. We're going to pick install for all users. Get the nice little wizard. Click next here. Click next again. It's checking for the command line for PHP. You're going to get this, click next, install. It's going to start running the composer installer scripts. Then you're going to get this, click on next, and then finish. Now we need to get, and we're going to click on Windows, and it's going to download the exe file once it's completed. Click on it to launch it up. Click next there, click next. I'm going to leave everything as the default. Click next, next, next. Basically, everything is the default. Just click next again, again, next, next, install. It's going to start installing it, and you're done. So what I did was uncheck view release notes, and I want to launch the programs, and then click next, and then it's going to launch up the command terminal. Now I'm going to go inside the www root folder and create a new folder and give it a name, and then go inside the folder and I'm going to copy that path. Now that path is where I'm going to drop the HTML, the images of the Snipe software into. Okay, so copy that path, go inside your Git terminal, and we need to run the following command. All right, so we're pulling all the Snipe files and we're dropping it inside this folder. This is my website. Okay, hit enter. It's going to start cloning, downloading all the information inside that folder. And once it's done, you're able to go back inside that folder and you're going to see everything that you need for Snipe to work correctly within your environment. So we need to do a couple of things, and we need to locate this file and make a copy of it. We are going to right click on it, and then we're going to rename it as the following, and then hit enter. Just hit yes here, and then we're good to go. Now right click on the file, and we need to edit. Now we need to take care of a couple of things within this file. So the first thing that we are going to take care of is the basic app settings. And the only thing that I'm going to change right here would be my app URL. This would be my app URL. Now, next thing that we need to take care of is the database settings. So we are going to click on start, and within start, we are going to open up MariaDB folder, and we are going to launch up the MySQL client command terminal. Awesome. Enter your password. And the first command that we are going to enter would be this. We are going to create a database called Snipe-IT. Awesome. I'm going to run a command of show database to make sure that the Snipe-IT database was created. Then we are going to run the following command to create a user, hit enter. And then we are going to give the new user access to our new database using this command here, hit enter. Then go back inside that env file and fill out the following information. Fill out your database name, the username, and the password. Now, the next thing that we need to do is configure your dump path. Now, to do that, we need to go inside program files, MariaDB, and your bin file is your dump file. But we need to hold the shift key, right click on that bin folder, and then click on copy as path. Once you do that, open up PowerShell and enter CMD, hit enter, and we need to run the following command, hit enter. Awesome. Now this echo is basically what we need to copy and then paste it inside the env file. But make sure you add an additional backslash like this, all right? Once you're done, save the file. Now click on start, and within start, we're going to type in CMD and then hit enter. All right, from here, we're going to change the directory to go inside our Snipe-IT folder, our website. We need to run the following command of composer install, hit enter. You're going to get some issues, and to fix this, we need to go inside the php.ini file and enter the following extension and then save the file. Go back inside your command prompt and start composer install again. You're going to see that it's going to start downloading and installing, and then you're good to go. Now within the command prompt, we need to generate a key with the following command, hit enter, type in yes, hit enter, and we're good to go. Now open up your IIS manager and open up sites. We need to stop the default website. We're going to select the sites folder, right click on it, add a website, enter your site name, physical path, and your host name. This is the information that I provided. Hit OK. Once you hit OK, select your new website, and we need to go inside mappings. And within mappings, we need to make the following changes. So locate the PHP Fast CGI, double click on it. Within the executable dialog box, make sure that that path is within double quotations. Click on request restrictions, go to verbs, and add the following verbs of delete, put, and patch, and then click OK. Okay, click yes here, and we need to do one more change. Locate the PHP 53 Fast CGI, double click on it. Make sure the executable path is inside double quotations. Click on request restrictions, go to verbs, and add the following verbs of delete, put, and patch, and hit okay. Okay, and then hit yes. Now within public and uploads, right click on it, and we need to change the permissions and add the internet user account and give it full control. Then we need to go inside Bootstrap and right click on cache and add the internet user and give that user account full control. Then we need to go inside storage, right-click on it, go to properties, go to security, and we need to enter internet user and give that user only modified rights to that particular folder. And then we need to go inside Windows, temp, you're going to add the internet user account and only give it modified rights. Then open up your favorite browser, type in your host name, hit enter, and it's gonna launch up the Snipe-IT, and you get green check marks, which is a good thing. And then you're going to click on create database table. I received this issue, so the way that I fixed it was the following. I needed to open up the command prompt. I changed the directory to go to my website, and I ran the following command to migrate, hit enter. I typed in yes, enter, done. Go back inside the site and you're going to see that it is going to state there was nothing to migrate. Your database tables were already set up. Then click on create new user. Enter all the information that's highlighted in orange. Once you're done there, click on save user and it takes you directly to your Snipe-IT asset management site. How awesome is that? Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to hit that thumbs up. Do not forget about punch, elbow, and smashing that subscribe button. Also, there's a little bell right there that you should just hit it to get notifications when I release something new. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.